and traded, and made other what? 5 talents. Verse 17. And likewise, he that received 2, he also did what? Gain other 2. The law of measure. The simple denomination of multiplication is what? By 2. And that by 2 cut across. Multiply 5 by 2, you get 10. Multiply 2 by 2, 2 by 2, you get 4. Simple. But something happened to the one that received 1. What did he do? But he, verse 18, that received 1, went and did what? And digged in the earth and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants cometh and reckoneth with them. If you read further down, the master was angry. The one that they gave 5 understood the principle because he had the heart to manage what was given to him. The one that had 2 also had the capacity. But the one that had 1 was a poor, wretched, frustrated, wicked servant. Even the Bible says the guy is a wicked man. Oh, let me show you. I'm closing now. Matthew 25, I will read verse 20. Are you there? 25, 20. What does it say? And so he that had received 5 talents came and brought other 5 talents, saying, Lord, thou deliverest unto me 5 talents. Behold, I have gained beside them 5 talents more. And the Lord said unto him, well done, thou good and faithful servant, thou hast been faithful to a few, and I will make you ruler over many things. Are you listening to me now? Now let's quickly move to verse 23. His Lord said unto him, well done, good and faithful servant. Put it as fine. Verse 24. Then he which had received 1 talent came and said, Lord, I know thee. The master also knew him, wicked man. I know thee that thou art a hard man. What has been hard? What is the connection between transacting what was given to you to the man being hard? Reaping where thou hast not sown. My goodness, can you see the mind? You can see a wicked mind. So the issue here is the mind. The reason why he attracted only 1 in the very first place was because he had a wicked heart. Now we are now seeing what that wicked heart can do. Can you imagine him telling the master, I know you're a wicked man, you always reap where you not sow. Can you imagine? Wicked heart. So I said to you again today, if it is still small in your heart, change it today by deliberately enlarging. How did that story end? Where are we now? Verse, what are we now? 24. And he which had received 1, okay, said, reap where thou had not sown, and gather it where thou had not what? Strong. Verse 25. And I was afraid, and went and hid your talent, wicked man, in the earth. No! Yeah, thou hast, that is thine. Take the one you gave me, take it back. Verse 26 is, Lord answered, and said unto him, thou wicked and slothful servant. So you see, he was a wicked man, he was a lazy man. So the point here wasn't the quantity. I don't know if you understand. It wasn't the quantity, it was his heart. It was his heart, his notion, his attitude, his perception. What is it with your heart that's not allowing money to multiply your heart? When you get it, you squeeze it, you keep it. Even to pay your tithe is a problem. To help a friend in need is a problem. It is me. When they see you in a restaurant, you will eat 5,000 naira, watch you. Have you ever seen a poor man eat? I bought you. Bread there. Mama? Shaggy. In one city. In one, that's why he's poor. And he feels, well, let me eat now. Another one will come. That's why they never get better. It's the same mentality that front stars use. 419ers, that's it. Now I have it. Let me just use it now. Let me see. It's a mindset. Put your 2 hands upon your head and say, God, have mercy upon me. Change my mind today. he says, verse 26, and the Lord said unto him, thou wicked and slothful servant, that knowest that I reap where I sow not, and gather where I am not strong. Thou ought therefore to have put my money to the exchangers, and then at my coming I should have received my own with usury, that's with interest. He said, take therefore the talent from him. Can you see the judgment? Take from him and give it to him that has 10. For unto everyone that hath shall be given, and he shall be what? Shall have abundance. But from him that hath not shall be taken away even that which he hath. Somebody will say, yeah, but God should have been merciful now. God does not show mercy to such people. Are you with me? It's all about transaction. It's all about transaction. Change your level by changing your giving. Even if that's all, there are days that, you know, we're going to have service, I'm probably in the office, and then suddenly I discover that I'm hungry, and I check my pocket, and I say to myself, if I eat with this money, what would be my offering for that day? And I would choose to be hungry. But you know what some of us will do? We will eat the money and hope that the speaker will come and bless us with offering. No! Whenever you are coming to church, you deliberately come. Because you see, I said to them in the second service, there's a physical component to your prosperity and there's a spiritual component to your prosperity. The spiritual component to your prosperity is what guarantees the multiplication of the physical component. You can sweat and work very hard, but if God does not have a part in your finances, you just remain what you would nothing to show. But if you secure God's own part, and I said to them in closing, I said, your first fruit secures your year. I said, your tithe establishes your finances and pushes away the barrier. But your giving is what creates favor that makes people give more to you. If your giving is small, the favor that will come back to you will be small. If your giving is great, the favor that will come back to you is great. So a man changes his financial fortune not by his title. His title secures his source. But a man teaches up his source by changing his giving and by making himself a radical giver. Make yourself a radical giver. By your own hand, you will change how favor will bring more into your life. Rise up with me as we close.